So it has been roughly over a month since the xenophobic attacks against many Nigerians in South Africa happened. We covered the story initially when the situation broke out, stating that an unavoidable repeat of the situation would happen again. What has happened over a month? Does it still look bad going forward? That is what we'll talk about today on Green Click. By the way, please give us a like and subscribe if you love these kinds of videos. It helps us make more videos you love about our amazing continent. Let's dive in. Let's see what has happened since the protests and attacks, shall we? So Buhari threatened to visit South Africa in a month's time. Has he done that yet? South African President Ramaphosa tried calming the xenophobia to no avail. Madagascar and Zambia cancelled their football games against South Africa to stand against the attacks. Twitter beef broke out between AKA and Burna Boy but apparently got squashed. This pastor threatened to deal with South Africa.
I will bring down your country to the ruest country.
We all use the hashtag Stop Xenophobia from the comfort of our phones. A Nigerian hero flew a bunch of Nigerians home. A group of South Africans protested for unity. The world ignored this whole story altogether because of the hurricanes and Trump's impending impeachment. And a few Africans took it upon themselves to stir the pot by posting fake videos unrelated to what was happening on the streets of South Africa. It is clear that the intensity of the situation has calmed down a bit. But what could we learn from the whole story? Well, a story usually has a catalyst, a hero, a villain, and a resolution. The attacks a month ago is the catalyst of the story, and we're talking about the victims and the oppressors in the event. Who are the villains? Surprisingly, it is us who did nothing about this. I mean, we talked about it right after adding hashtag Stop Xenophobia, but did absolutely nothing to get the world involved. And just a disclaimer, GreenClick is part of the villains as well. And with your villains, you need the heroes. And in the case of the recent events, it is safe to call Chief Allen Onyema one of the heroes of the story, as he volunteered to offer free flights from South Africa to Nigeria for those who feared for their lives in South Africa. Another hero or heroes are the South Africans who, despite being surrounded by fellow countrymen who are not fond of foreigners, went on a protest to apologize for the attacks. So, is there a happy ending to all of this? It does not seem so. And it does not seem like there ever will be an end to the story, as it is a recurring concept that could rear its ugly head in the next 5 years. Unless South Africa can improve its workforce and societal structure, the oppressed will keep oppressing others. If you have reached this stage of the video, we would like to thank you for sharing your time with us, but comment below if you have a different take on the whole situation. We'd love to hear your side of this. If you'd like to be informed when we roll out new videos, give us a like to help us with the YouTube algorithm. Share this with a friend and drop a comment if you disagree or would like to request a video. Till then, brothers and sisters, have a nice day.